I'd like to share an example of an exercise that I do with my students that are beginning their adventure into mixing, into music production, and how to get the conversation started, getting assistance from an external entity. It could be AI, of course, but let's do an example with just music production. So this is something that I do with my students to kind of get them started with assistance. I have a beat, I have a vocal, and our job in this experience, in this exercise, is going to be to find a keyboard part. We come in and record, what are the chords? C, F, G, C, F, G, cool. We put the MIDI dots in there. And I do it with a whatever sound, and the uglier, the better. So then the exercise is this. I tell students, what should this part feel like? And again, I try to just go into the creative. What do they want this part to express? What are the lyrics saying? Are the lyrics about angst? Is it cute? Is it energetic? Is it creepy? What is it? And then we're gonna try to find a sound, at least a feeling, identify a feeling, right? So here's the assistance. I put in a synth, a plugin, right? Like an AI plugin, but let's call it just a keyboard synth. And then I tell them, in your mind, let's say that we want a creepy sound. I hit play in loop and I start going through the presets. Yes, the presets. The thing that it made on its own, and there are 32 presets of infinite possibilities, which if you open up a list of presets that somebody else suggested, it's a daunting task. Which one of these is the good one? But you have a direction. The direction is this thing needs to feel creepy. Okay. So then I hit play, it loops, and I start going through the presets. One, two, three. Three is the one that feels closer to me. Okay. So now we have had external assistance and we decided which one was the better one. This gives this ocean of possibilities a more limited window now. Now we're going to dig in and focus more. So then I start making prompts for my students saying, well, is it creepy enough? Is it too creepy? So this is an emotional endeavor, right? I also give them technical considerations. For example, when we use this suggested assisted sound, how is this symbiotically connecting with the sound of the rest of the instruments? How is this sound gelling with the beat and with the vocal? Is it masking the beat because we have too much low end? Is it not? Is it making the whole mix sound too harsh because it has too much mid-range and it's actually covering the vocal? So let's recapitulate. We have an ocean of possibilities. We have an emotional objective. We get assistance from this external thing. We go through the presets. Ah, this one feels like the objective that we want. And then we have the bifurcation of two different areas of concentration. One is dig into the emotional. Is it creepy enough? Is it not creepy enough? And then a technical. How is it symbiotically? The frequency, the spatial, and the dynamic aspects of this sound, how is it symbiotically connecting to the rest of the production, to the rest of the arrangement? We evaluate and we come out with a set of results, right? It's not creepy enough. It's too harsh in the mid-range. Then that's the prompt and invitation for my students to go in to the plugin, the synthesizer, the external help, and tweak and customize and make perfect. According to who? To them. To their unique vision of what it could be. So this is an exercise that I invite you to just take the concepts from what I've said and apply them to your creative endeavors, and hopefully that gets the conversation started and the help for the humans to be welcome, but we are the ones that really, really bring it home.